Welcome to Heat's Big Night In. I'm Emily, we are with Talk Talk TV, and we are diving in to your favourite shows over the weekend. So X-Factor, we're going to be talking about Strictly, joined by the guests that have experienced it firsthand. Can we have a massive round of applause? Fresh from X-Factor this weekend, it is Louise! You're amazing, girl.
Thank you.
You are unbelievable. R&B goddess who knows a lot about vocals, Mabel. Give it up for Mabel. Francis from Made in Chelsea will be here. He is on his way. So let's just start with you, Louise.
Okay.
Huge congratulations.
Thank you.
Standing ovation.
I know.
Were you surprised at that, though?
I really was, yeah. I wasn't expecting that response. I really wasn't.
But you were like, you were so confident. Like, I mean, like for Mabel, for you it's different because you come out and you're performing to like fans, for example. So it's not like judges there. But do you still experience nerves?
Yeah, I think it's good to be nervous. Yeah. I think I'm worried when I'm not nervous. Do you know what I mean? I think I would be. I'm always like the butterflies. It's all part of the journey. Yeah, and then you get out there and you're like, it's a release. Mm. You know,
yeah.
It's good.
On X Factor, you can say, like, oh, I'm really nervous, like, ready to perform. But you just like, right, let's do this, I am ready. And it was just amazing.
But I'm glad I came across like that, because I didn't feel like that inside. Even watching the performance back on Saturday, I was bricking it.
Well, do you know
And
what?
It was already done.
Let's remind ourselves, if anyone's not seeing it, this is the moment Louise auditioned for the X Factor.
Spare me a moment of your time. And I swear I'll make it worth your while. Give me a chance to prove our change, and I'll never break your heart again.
You actually came on with your own song. That's proper brave. Well, I don't know how you feel, but whenever they say, oh, I'm going to start with my own material, I'm like, oh, no, don't do it. But it worked.
Yeah, and it was a risk for me because I'd never sung that song before to an audience. I wrote it years ago and I never sang it. Yeah, it was the first time.
And your boys were there?
They was there, yeah.
Super excited. Did they get the day off from school in the end? Because I know they were asking.
They did, because we got home so late.
Right, okay, yeah. I'm going to explain that to a teacher. I don't know about you as well. Like, I always think, and if you did the X Factor, I always think it's Simon that you want to stand up.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
That's the tough cookie.
He's the one,
Yeah. You're like, if he doesn't stand, you're like, oh, God.
I'll just go home.
Yeah.
Shut myself up.
Obviously, we need to talk about another moment from X Factor. I don't know if he was actually on the same day as you. It was a guy called J Soul.
Oh, yeah.
And that was like,
oh, no.
You know, when you're like, oh, God, this is just going to mess up my makeup.
Emotional.
Mm. Let's just remind ourselves of J Soul's audition.
The song is a song I wrote called Bullet in My Heart. And I suddenly lost my mum in 2015.
We've lost our way somehow. Been waiting all this time. Yeah.
I think when someone comes on with a story, or like, you know, there's a backstory, sometimes people like can be a bit like, oh, who, you know. But with that, I just felt like, I think because Louis Tomlinson, one of the judges, has gone through it as well. Also, Ida was saying that she'd like lost her father. You just are rooting for someone like that.
Of course, yeah.
You know, and like, I mean, I don't know how you, because you write your own songs, obviously Mabel as well. Is it better when they are like personal?
Yeah, I think everything I write is personal. It's all like to process things and to just make sense of things. That's why I write songs, you know.
Yeah.
And then when other people relate, that's when like the magic happens.
Yeah,
definitely.
Because that's what happened with you as well. Because like, I think more people on X Factor, and it's working, are like coming out with their own material. And you used to be quite nervous, like, oh, don't sing a song we know.
I think like writing songs is like therapy for me.
Yeah.
It's like stuff that I don't talk about, I put into songs. And I think someone out there can relate to that.
Yeah.
What you've written about, you're not the only person that's gone through
exactly.
that.
Is that how you feel as well?
Yeah, for sure.
Mm. Yeah.
It's just like, you know, to relate to other people, start a conversation well, like a dialogue about things. Sometimes it's easier to put
and
it in a song.
You're like, you're in it. I mean, like you're in the industry, you'd like touring and stuff. What advice would you give to Louise, who's like stepping into it now?
Just like, yeah, never change. Like, you know best. Your vision is like, that's what people want. They want people to be themselves. But then there's also this like misconception of that, like you need to fit some kind of mold or whatever. But actually, you're going to be successful just off the back of being you. And it sounds simple, but sometimes it's hard because people will try and
tell you that you have to do this.
Yeah, they have to do this or wear that, and actually it's not true at all.
You
can just 100% be yourself.
I think like the audience are always really smart as well. When they know someone's copying someone or trying to be like
for sure,
don't they?
Yeah.
They're so harsh, and I'm if I like went on there like Britney Spears, I think everyone would be like, she's just trying to
be Britney.
Exactly,
Right, we need to talk about X Factor. So there was some moments, shocking moments in X Factor. We also need to talk about Strictly Come Dancing, which started this weekend. And I want to show you a moment now, which everyone was talking about. They weren't happy about on Twitter. This is Judge Shirley's comments on Sean Walsh's performance.
You're a very good-looking man, and I love your hair. But when I watch Tango, I want to see something just a little bit more classic. I mean, maybe tie it back a little bit, keep it free for the Latin. But nice heel leads. There were some nice little things that you did in there, but not the normal Tango that I'm used to seeing. It was definitely more contemporary. But tidy yourself up a little bit. It was flying all over. A little bit more tidy.
Do we think that was mean, like, about his hair? Like, I actually really like his hair.
I like his hair.
Yeah, I think it's crazy. Like, she should just be judging his dancing. What has his hair got anything to do with it? I think it's crazy. It's wild to me.
And it wasn't as if it was in the way. Like, do you know what I mean? It wasn't as if it was,
it's just
like,
his hair.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
And I just think... I think it must be so nerve-wracking doing Strictly.
I couldn't do that. Imagine. I dance like Garfield.
No. I'm not very coordinated.
You know, the cat, the ginger cat.
Oh, yeah, just... God, sorry. I'm just like,
oh, yeah, that. Oh, yeah, but that's kind of... Yeah,
yeah.
I like that.
Yeah, no,
with
that's not good when I do it. good when you do it, but not me.
I don't know if that would cut it on Strictly. I think for the first week, I feel like you're just trying to get through it. Like, I don't know how you felt on X Factor. You're like, I just need to not mess up.
Get it done.
Yeah.
Do you feel like that on a show, where you're like, don't
Definitely. Yeah, definitely. Like, that's it.
And I think to, like... focus on his hair was just a little bit
that must be so disappointing when you've actually got through it and then the judge your is hair. Like right, do you know what, your hair, it's like, mate, I just spent a week trying to figure this dance out, but and I've just done it and you're talking about my hair.
That is so harsh.
It's not right.
And then he was like, why don't you say whether I'm sweaty or I smell, like, it wasn't cool. Actually, I didn't think that was cool, Shirley.
No, it wasn't.
Another moment from Strictly over the weekend. Let's just focus in here on Lee and Nadia.
You can spend all your time making money. Take it to the limit one more time.
Did you see the chemistry?
It's a lot.
There's a lot of chemistry there.
Yeah, that was hot, that was sweaty. In fact, actually, Darcy, who I think is quite PC, said lustful.
Ooh. Lustful.
Lustful. That's a sexy word.
Amazing.
You've heard of the Strictly curse?
I have.
Yeah?
I'm aware of the Strictly curse.
Yeah.
So is this it? Is this the couple?
I don't want to say anything because I think... I don't know if he's in a relationship. I feel like she might be engaged.
Is it another love triangle? Yeah.
So I feel like we maybe
just
need to let you
this
said
one.
It, not me.
Oh, okay.
No. I'm kidding. You can see how it happens, though, right? You can see.
Yeah, I just think like it's music and dance and like seeing this very emotional thing.
It's very
you feel
emotional.
Everything,
yeah.
Didn't you?
And they're spending so much time together. Getting sweaty.
Getting sweaty. Hair's going everywhere. I do feel like Lee's a cheeky boy. You know, I know Lee Ryan really well. I don't.
Just some different things like Big Brother.
Yeah,
definitely. The love triangle with him and
it was deep. Yeah, and he's flirty. He's been in that boy band kind of like kind of vibe. So
you heard it here first.
Yeah,
basically.
We're watching. Yes, you heard it here first. It's not all about what we're saying though. We are loving your reactions on social media. Twitter X Factor was trending, so we're going to do a roundup of our favourites. We're going to be joined back here by Francis from Made in Chelsea. We're going to talk about his private parts, and we're going to be talking to Mabel about her brand new single.
Hey girl, you better check your tweets.
Oi, that tweet was sick blood.
As we all know, the best part of watching TV along with the rest of the nation are the reactions. So we have collated some of our favourite tweets about this weekend's Strictly and X Factor. In fifth place, Robbie Williams' comfort over style approach didn't go unnoticed by viewers. In fourth, some viewers clearly are taking issue with Pussycat doll Ashley Roberts' previous dance experience. In third, not content with one 1D member, this person is threatening legal action if she doesn't get a few more. In second, he may not be on the show anymore, but pro dancer James Jordan is still giving his expert opinion. And in first, speaking of Anton and Susanna's dance, Heat Radio presenter Emma Bullimore is taking up a case with the BBC. Back to you, Emily.
Welcome back to Heat's Big Night In. I am joined by, obviously, Louise, fresh from X Factor this weekend. Francis now joins us from Made in Chelsea. Give up for Francis! Thank you for being here. And obviously, the goddess of R&B, Mabel.
Wow, no pressure.
Francis, I've just been seeing loads of you, your private parts, with our very own Jamie Lang, actually. It's been the two of you. Tell us about this podcast that you're doing.
Well, I mean, we've been doing it for now, I think, 18 months or something. Yeah. And it started just basically because Jamie and I, we've known each other for a very long time.
Were you actually friends before Made in Chelsea?
Yeah, so we kind of knew of each other, and we'd met a couple of times at parties or whatever, yeah. But we didn't become very good friends until we did the show.
Right.
But you know, kind of everyone on that show knew each other from, you know, school days and stuff like that, and so then we kind of finally decided to record a podcast because that's I guess the epitome of that, right? Bottling up a conversation and allowing other people to listen to it
with no limitations,
our own sort of total editorial control, and
because you took it to Edinburgh, right?
Yeah, so we didn't take the podcast to Edinburgh. There's a lot of maybe a bit of confusion perhaps about this, but our private parts live, the show that we took to Edinburgh, which was a sellout hit.
Way.
Luckily. Great. Basically, that's actually a script. It's a show. It's a scripted show that we've written, which is kind of, it's kind of more like, I guess it's kind of more like a two-man comedy show.
Yeah. Now, why do we see Jamie naked and we haven't seen you naked?
What? I mean, I'm surprised you're even asking that.
That was just feedback we got.
Jamie's, you know, likely to get naked at any opportunity. Yeah, yeah. So, do you know what? I remember writing that bit in and thinking, God,
stitched him up.
There's loads of stuff in there. I was like, is he going to agree to this? And he's like, yeah. the next thing, we're standing in our technical rehearsal about to go, obviously, on stage the next day in Edinburgh, and our director was like, okay, so Jamie, this is where you're going to be standing completely naked before you run on. And then it just sort of, there was this moment where it dawned on him that he'd agreed to be naked at 23 cities around the country.
Oh god. Wow, brave. But no, so where can we get tickets, because that's happening now,
so
right?
You can buy tickets right now. I mean, there are a few left, but if you want to get tickets, we're coming to 23 cities around the cities and towns around the country. So go to privatepartspodcast.com.
Okay, brilliant. So privatepartspodcast.com.
Sorry, okay. Privateparts.com is a completely different thing.
Don't go on that website. Sorry, I don't know why that was
privatepartspodcast.com.
Good. Mabel, let's talk about your new single. So yes. New single called One Shot.
It is.
I love the Burberry suit, by the way.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. You need, like, when you make your first music video, watch Mabel's for the wardrobe inspiration.
The look.
So where did you shoot the video for One Shot?
We shot it in Toronto.
Right.
And it was crazy because I have body doubles. So there's supposed to be four of me, which, like, thank God there's only one of me. It would be a lot for the world to deal with.
God.
It was like a crazy experience. Like, everybody on my team kept walking up to them because they literally looked exactly like me from behind. It was very strange.
Have to go and find, like, three other people that look exactly like me.
Yeah.
That's an amazing job.
Not really the face. It was like body doubles.
Right.
Um, And I was very impressed, yeah.
Yeah, they look like you. On those kind of, like you said, it was shot in Toronto. I always think this with like music videos. Do you go, I'd like to shoot it in California, please? Like, do you
get sometimes that? It's like, I really wanted to shoot a video in South Africa last year.
Yeah.
So then we found a director. Found a director, wanted to shoot in Johannesburg, found a director that's like from there and sort of did it that way. And then this time round, it was like, I read a treatment that I really liked and really liked the director. And then he was from Toronto and was like, I would love to shoot it here.
Yeah, yeah.
So it just depends.
Wow, that's like pretty cool. So that's hopefully like what, have you thought about what you would do like for music video wise for your single that you like performed on the X Factor?
Well, it would have to feature my children because they've been all over the X Factor. It's been all about them.
Yes, it has.
Yeah,
this is true.
All about them.
They want a bit of this. Like,
They think it's about them. Yeah. They do. Like,
our video.
Yeah.
We're like, come on, watch the X Factor so we can see ourselves.
Yeah. I love it.
They love themselves so much.
They were very cute. I love that they were in matching shirts.
They always wear matching. Like, They think they're out on the deck.
Really?
Yeah, I love it.
There was like, so did me and Jamie, actually. Yeah.
Do you know what this could do for our future, Isaac? I know, William.
That's so sweet.
They're great. Cute.
You've got to get them Twitter, Instagram.
They want it all.
Oh, God.
You're
going to have to get them an agent. Maybe, like, yes.
I know, exactly. Yes, it's their moment. Yeah, yeah.
Do you get friends that are like, oh, can we come to Toronto with you in South Africa?
Do you know what? I love travelling with my friends, but we do make up, like, some, like, when I do shows, like festivals, I've always, like, got one of my friends doing hair and like on the list. People are always like, really? Because it looks like you guys are just hanging out. Yeah. But cool.
No, she's my hair.
Yeah, literally.
Brilliant. Oh, I know what I wanted to ask you about, Mabel.
Yes.
You've actually toured with Harry Styles.
I have, yes.
Who is obviously with Louis Tomlinson, who's one of the judges this year. And he pied you in the face.
Yes, he did.
I haven't gotten back to you yet.
We've all seen the video.
Because he did it on the last day of tour. So we were on the road for a month. And on my last night, and literally my impression of him so far, lovely.
Yeah, yeah.
Lovely guy. And I'm just on stage and I'm singing Finders Keepers, my last song. And I'm looking out. We're in Dublin. It's very emotional. I'm like, wow. Something literally just is all over. I see it like a second before it hits my face. And I think, oh my God, somebody from the crowd.
That's what you did.
This is so embarrassing. I was like, I thought it was pretty good.
Does this mean that you owe him one?
So basically, I owe him one. But I turned around, I was like, managed to get the cream out of my eyes, turn around, and Harry's there and he's like, it's vegan. Because obviously he's still being considerate that I don't eat
that
dairy.
That is so sweet. So, it's vegan, I swear.
And then he left for Australia for the rest of the tour, so I haven't had time to get him back. That suggestions, please.
Yeah, yeah.
He has a song called
Are
Kiwi.
Are you both, like, nominated for a Grammy or something?
I know what I mean. I'm just like, I'm going to get I'm going to get one of his suits
so
at some point.
You need, like, a Kiwi prank or something like that.
Well, yeah, because Kiwi?
I know he has a song called Kiwi, so I feel like I should do something with Kiwis. Yeah, yeah. I don't know. Any suggestions?
Your aunt and Jeff on it or something, I feel like they're
Definitely.
Yeah, it was very rude, to be honest, and it was all in my hair.
Literally didn't even ask.
That was the worst thing. But I carried on, which I think now looking back, I probably just should have left because I'm singing. Yeah. And as I'm singing, I'm like, my whole face is just covered. I was like, this is my moment. This is my favourite bit of the set. And you're really trying to steal this moment from me, Harry. It's not cool. He could have done it as I left.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I was hoping that, you know, when they go to, obviously, judges' houses and we see Louis' house, you always have a person, don't you? They have a person with them.
Yeah.
So, like, Simon has Cheryl. So, you know, I don't know if there's something, if Harry's there, that you could do on behalf of Mabel.
That would be really sweet.
Yeah.
Please. He's been hiding from me ever since. So, if you see him,
if you find him,
he knows, doesn't he? He's going to get it.
Right. Are you ready for a game? Because what chat show would be a chat show without a game?
Yeah, is that what that is?
Let's do it.
Yes, we'll come to this, France. No. We'll come to this. Right, are you ready for a big night in spin?
Let's do it.
Yeah. Here we go. Are you ready for Heat's big night in spin?
Yes.
Mabel, you ready?
I'm ready.
Francis, you ready?
Yeah.
Louise, you ready?
I'm ready, okay. Yeah.
Only one of you are doing the challenge, so you don't have to worry too much. So, how it's going to work is, as you can see, each segment has a picture. It relates to our favourite TV show. Microphone for X Factor. We've got Dancing for Strictly, and we've got a crocodile for I'm a Celeb, which we will be talking about when it starts, but it's not started yet. So, I have here each of your names on a card. Louise, I'll let you do the honours if you pick one of the cards.
reveal who's doing the challenge.
Is that
yeah, that's fine. Oh, it's Francis. Oh, Francis, you are doing the challenge. No, we don't need to look at them. That's fine. Nothing's rigged. You're doing it fair and square. Right. So, Francis, I'm going to spin it, and then you're going to get a challenge.
All right.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, still spinning.
There. Okay. Oh. Singing. How's your singing voice, Francis?
Terrible.
Right. It's good. It's a good start. Well, Mabel, you know vocals and so does Louise, so I'm sure we can all help you out
it's
here.
Fine. We'll be good.
Right. If you would take yourself over to the challenge area, please, Francis, get yourself ready. Yay. Give it up for Francis. I'm going to take the remote from you, and we are going to now watch him on the big screen. Who's in the TV?
Who's in the TV? I said, who's in the TV?
Oh, look, Francis is in the screen. Give it up for Francis. You look so vulnerable. Are you all right in there?
I'm fine.
You're fine, yeah. It looks like, what's that, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, you know, where they go into the TV. Okay, so you obviously got the microphone, which means you're going to sing, okay?
Yes.
All right. I'm going to sing some. I'm going to talk some lyrics at you, actually, because I'm really bad at singing. You need to finish it, but you need to sing it. Okay. First lyric. We've come too far to give up who we are, so let's raise the bar and our cups to the stars.
Oh right. Okay. She's up all night to get lucky.
Hey. Okay. You've got to know this one.
Okay.
Girl,
and that
you know,
was by Thingy, what's his name?
Yeah, exactly.
Daft Punk. Bonus point for getting that. Right, okay. Second song, Francis. Girl, you know I want your love. Your love was handmade for somebody like me.
I'm in love with the shape of you.
Yay! Francis, that was terrible, but well done. You completed your challenge. You can now come back over.
Great.
Well done, Francis. Well done. Thank you so much to all our guests for being here. Mabel, give it up for Mabel. Francis from Maine and Chelsea. Don't forget to buy your tickets. Not to privateparts.com, privatepartspodcast.com.
That's it. That's it.
And Louise from XFactor. Massive good luck to you. Good luck to Louise. Thank you so much. This is Heat's Big Night In, where we are going to be dissecting and getting all the gossip from your favourite shows. We'll be back next week, same time, same place. Give it up one more time for my guests. Woo!